that's good. They do.
It's good. It's good.
Just relax and do yoga.
Yeah, that's it.
Don't need to rush.
Start with an opening prayer. You can chant along with me, or you can chant after me. You can chant after me. Om Sahana Bhavatu.
Om Sahana Bhavatu.
Sahana Bhunaktu.
Sahana Bhunaktu.
Sahaviryam Karava.
Sahaviryam karavavahai.
Tejasvinavaditamastu mavidvishavahai.
Tejasvinavaditamastu mavidvishavahai.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
As you exhale, slowly come forward.
Take the boat to the neck.
Slowly come back up. Come to shining pose. Left hand. We'll first start with a big body synchronization. Then we'll do an IRT and then we'll do a dynamic pose. Let's start with the big body synchronization. Let's bring both of your hands and interlock your hands. As you breathe in, extend your arms front and look. Breathe out, come back. Breathe in, and breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. And the next, we'll raise our hands at 60 degrees or 45 degrees. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. The next, slowly we raise our hands to up 90 degrees. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And also breathe in. Breathe out. Bring both your hands down and relax and slowly do your breath. And come back to Tadasana with your shoulder rotations. You will coordinate with the breath. So as you inhale, slowly bring your both your shoulders, roll your shoulders up. As you inhale, bring them forward. As you exhale, you bring them forward. As you inhale, them up. Let's do it clockwise, again coordinated with the breath. Okay, let's start. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. So your shoulder movement is guided by your breath. So breathe in. Breathe out. Let's do the reverse way. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Come back to relax. Let's do the same the neck rotation. So we'll do a full neck rotation. We'll first do a half, we'll do a sideways and then we'll do a full neck rotation. So you can look at me and you can start in Shiddhi Tadasana and you can start doing it. As you breathe in, turn to your right and slowly look towards, you have your gaze drawn completely to your right, and as you breathe out, come back to center. As you breathe in, left, breathe out, center. You can make the movements slow, very slow and very gently. You don't want to hurt your neck muscles. You can close your eyes and you can open your eyes. Actually, you can open your eyes too. It's more, because you're having a gaze also. So, we'll start at the right and then we'll move the left. We'll do a couple of rounds. Okay? Breathe in. Breathe out. Center. And breathe in. Side. Breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, and last one, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Okay. Now let's do the neck rotation very slowly, very gently. You can close your eyes too. So you can see me. As you breathe in, slowly turn your right, your neck towards clockwise right side. As you exhale, once you go back, as you exhale, make it come back to center. Again, inhale, right and up, exhale, left and down. Okay, let's do again, the whole movement should be gone into the break. Okay, start again. Breathe in. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. When you're done, stop at the center, okay? And we'll do a reverse way again. We'll do the very opposite of breathing. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, very slow and very gentle, breathe out, and last round, after you are done, come back to center, and you can slowly open your eyes, with the relaxation. We'll do a quick IRT and then we'll move to the dynamic poses or physical poses. For doing IRT, lie down on the shavasana, on the mat in shavasana. Okay. Slowly bring your legs, both legs together, and hands by the side of your body. Okay. Start the instant relaxation technique. Slowly start tightening your toes, and then your ankles, shins. Knee, pull your kneecap up and tighten, and pull your thigh muscle up and tighten it, and tighten your glutes and the pelvis region, and exhale and tighten your stomach or abdomen region, and inhale and expand your chest, tighten your hands, tighten your fists, tighten your facial muscles, tighten the entire body, tighten, and release. And let's do one Omkara. Feel the relaxation in the body. And slowly observe your breath. and slowly turns your continuous right. With the head of your both hands slowly rise up. Let's come to standing pose. We will do a yogic jogging as a loosening of one of exercise. The yogic jogging, try to have both your hands near your chest center. We'll do three poses. In the first pose, we'll slowly do a small jogging, just leaning. And very slowly, as you warm up, you can step outside your mat. So, the next step will, there is an increase of speed, but try to kick our butts with their legs. Okay. Increase your speed. Make your thighs parallel to the ground. Do the side kicks. Slow down. Let's do one round again with the high knees. Slow down. Back to the mat. So you start observing your breath. You can stand in Shiklatalasana. Your heart rate is very high. You slowly start observing the breath and make it low. You can do a Mukha Dhauti to keep out the tempo. For the Mukha Dhauti, bend your knees slightly and lean forward and keep your hands in your thighs and start paging at least 3 to 4 feet ahead. And here we are doing a very forced exhalation. Have a breathing and as if you are blowing a candle in front of you, try to blow the candle as fast as forcefully as you can. We'll do one more loosening practice, which is a triangle pose and modified triangle parvartan trikonasana. So for that, go to the right edge of your mat and extend your feet 3 feet and raise your both hands. Now bring your right hand onto your right leg and extend your left arm up and you're looking up, and the next time raise the right hand back up and we'll do the left hand side. Okay, so you try, so you'll repeat this. Okay, so right, left, right, left, right, left, again, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Let's slowly come back to center and bring both your hands down and stay where you are. Now we'll do, let's bend forward a little bit from our waist. And now this time we'll try to touch with your right hand, you'll try to touch with your left foot and have your gaze up and looking your left hand. Okay, and we'll repeat the other way. We'll do this and then we'll switch to the left hand to the right foot and we'll look up the right hand. Okay, so we'll do a little faster round of this.
So again, we'll start, bend forward. So now right hand touching left, and left touching right,
right, left, 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 right, left. Okay, we'll come back. And we can bring the next to there. And let's get on the shavasana. Start observing the breath. So when you are ready, you can come back to Makarasana. So return your body. And you can look at me.
So what we'll be doing now is again a diagonal pose. We'll switch from high bhujangasana to parvatasana. So in the first pose, you are in the makrasana, and we start with the starting sthiti, and bring both your hands near to your chest. You're raising up in the high bhujangasana first, and immediately you are switching to parvatasana. Okay, in the high bhujangasana again, when you are doing Bhujangasana, you are lifting your knees up. That's when you will feel the more effect of this loosening. And then Parvatasana. Bhujangasana, Parvatasana. Okay? We'll start with this. We'll start with the Bhujangasana. Okay, let's stay in the Bhujangasana. Okay, then Parvatasana. Okay, Bhujangasana, Parvatasana. Bhujangasana, Parvatasana. Let's do faster rounds. Bhujangasana, Parvatasana. Bhujangasana, Parvatasana. Bhujangasana, Parvatasana. Okay. Now come back to Makarasana position. So one common thing I saw both of you doing when you are in the Parvatasana, always try to have both feet down. Because both of you are having your feet up, so try to have both feet down. And if you raise the hip region, so essentially you are extending completely your back. Okay, so in the Parvatasana, relax for a little. Next we will do an ayati. You can switch back to the shavasana push. Close your eyes. Yeah, both hands are looking up. Palms are facing towards sky. I slowly start observing your breath. And as you inhale, start observing your stomach going up, and exhale, going down. Inhale, up, exhale, down. Start observing your breath, so inhale, up, exhale, down. Inhale, up, exhale, down. Now try to do the deep breathing as you inhale deeply. Relaxation in the body, no tension anywhere. Inhale up, exhale down. We chant in Akara. Next,
as you inhale. You exhale, start saying start feeling a complete relaxation in the body. And when you are ready, lift your right hand up, bring both your palms together, feet together, and move your left leg and turn towards right and slowly come back up. Keep your eyes closed. And when you are ready, slowly come back up. We'll do a few asanas. Standing asanas, then we'll move to sitting in supine and prone. In the standing asana, we'll start with this Rukshasana. We can start with the Rukshasana. And then we'll do another Chakrasana before we move to the sitting pose. So in the Rukshasana, we are trying to balance our body on one leg. So you can observe me. So slowly in the first stage, I'll shift my weight to the right leg. And slowly when I'm possible, like if I'm not able to balance my completely on the right leg. This is the easiest pose where you can keep your left leg in the lower part of the right leg. And with both your hands. Important is the stability. If you can go little up, then never go to the knee. If you can go all the way, go all the way to the ground region. And raise your hands and have a gauge breath. Okay, we'll start with your right leg first. So slowly start your shift your weight to your right leg. So start your starting position should be your Tadasana. And slowly shift your weight to your right leg, and when you are ready, slowly raise your left leg and keep it on the, if you can go all the way, keep it all the way to up, and have your, you can keep your hands in the sideways, or actually if you can take it all the way, keep it all the way up. So closing your eyes normally sometimes causes imbalance, like if you call, you're not able to balance yourself closing, you can keep your eyes open. Yeah, it's okay to come down, but ensure you are coming, you are staying in the pose. You can it will improve if you can fix your target, a gauge on a one fixed object in front of you and you are looking at it. Body stable on one leg, right leg. So as you exhale, you can bring both your hands down first and then bring your feet down. We'll do the same thing on the left leg. Again, starting position is on the Tadasana. So in the Tadasana, actually both your feet are together. Your kneecaps are slightly pulled up, buttocks is tightened. And your shoulders are relaxed and you're standing firm. So now slowly shift your weight to your left leg. And you can start by lifting the right leg up. If you can go all the way, you can go all the way, otherwise keep it in the other hand. With your hands as you need. We'll do a count to 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now slowly as you exhale, bring your arms down and bring your legs down. So we'll next do the Ardhakati Chakrasana. So in this, first as you inhale, raise your hand. Right hand towards center, and then slowly as you exhale, turn it to up face your palm up, and as you inhale, raise it, and your shoulder blades are touching your ears, and as you inhale, please bring the hands up, extend the arms up, and as you exhale, you're keeping it down, moving to the left side. And inhale, come back up. Inhale, and as you exhale, bring the arms to center. As you inhale, turn it down. And as you exhale, bring the hand to it. And do the same with the left hand. So as you inhale, raise your left hand up. Your hands are parallel to the ground. As you exhale, turn the palm facing towards the sky. As you inhale, bring the arm up. Your shoulder blades are touching your ears. As you inhale, again, so slowly extend your palm up, stretch it up. And as you exhale, bend to your right. As you inhale, slowly come back up. As you exhale, bring your palms down. As you inhale, turn your palms facing towards the ground. And as you exhale, bring your hands down. So we will start with the we can now do the sitting position, and then we'll go to supine. First, okay. The sitting position, we'll start with the sukhasana. We'll do one sitting position, and then we'll do supine. Okay. In the sitting position, the first the pose we are going to do is called paschimottanasana. The paschimottanasana, you're starting, you extend your legs in front of you. So as you inhale, you raise both your hands up. So as you exhale, bend your body down in front of you. If you can go all the way, try to touch your toes. It's important to actually have your knees completely on the ground. You should not raise it. So it's okay if you can't stretch all the way, but let's keep both the feet completely on the ground. Okay? So this has a nice stretch towards your back. Stay there for the count of 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, slowly come back up. As you inhale, bring both hands up, and as you exhale, bring your palms down. Then come back to Sukhasana. Okay, come back to Sukhasana. So we'll do one supine pose and then one prone pose. The supine pose, so your starting station is a shavasana, and then you bring both, so what we are going to do is a naukasana. So bring both your feet together and palms closer to your body. So as you inhale, slowly raise your legs up. They are 60 degrees or 45 degrees, whatever. So you bring your upper body up. And the whole weight is balanced on the whole body is lifted up, only the butt is on the ground. Okay, so there's a huge contraction on the abdomen. It's very good for that. So we can start in the shavasana. Slowly bring both your feet together and hands to the side of your body. So as you inhale, lift your legs up 60 degrees. As you exhale, next time bring your upper body up and you're trying to balance. huge stretch on your abdomen. So as you slowly bring your upper body down, let's slowly bring your feet down. Slowly start with the breath. Next we'll do is a Paschimottanasana. You can see my demo position, then you can do a Paschimottanasana. So we'll come back to the Makarasana course. So start with the Paschimottanasana. Again, our starting sthiti is Shavasana. You bring both your feet together and hands by the side of your body. Like now, asana will first raise our legs up, but this time towards 90 degrees. So as you inhale, now we slowly try to bring both feet towards the back side of the body like a last breath, and we will try to hold our back with your arms. So as you exhale, slowly bring both your feet down.
It's
called Alasa. Okay, so you bring both your feet together. So as you inhale, lift your legs up. And your next exhale, try to bring both your feet towards the back side. And you can balance with your hands. So let's just count to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you exhale, slowly bring your both feet completely on the ground. Start observing your breath slowly. Then relax for some time in the Shavasana. So when you are ready, you can turn into the Makarasana pose. So we'll do one, this time we'll do a prone pose. In the prone pose, your starting sthiti is, the prone pose is, you're extending your arms in front of you. And so the first pose we'll do is a Bhujangasana. So we will do a high Bhujangasana first and then the real Bhujangasana. The high Bhujangasana have both your hands right by the side of your chest. And as you inhale, you're lifting yourself up completely and looking up. Okay, this is the first pose. You stay there for some time. And the real Bhujangasana, actually there's a very little weight on your hands and you're actually lifting with your upper body. And your feet are like together and they are all touching. They are not up, they are just completely on the ground. Okay, so let's start the high Bhujangasana. So as you inhale, raise yourself up completely with the help of your hand. And your gaze is up. You can start keep normal breath when you are up. You need to hold your breath. So when you have an inhale, when you do a next exhale, try to come down. we'll do the other bhujangasana, the variation of the bhujangasana. In this case, you are again raising yourself up, but you are using your upper body to raise yourself up. There's a very little weight on your hands, both your hands. So as you inhale, rise up. Again, keep normal breathing. Don't hold your breath. So after you inhale, next exhale, try to come down. And come down. After you inhale. And let's return and switch to the Shavasana pose. So we'll do a DRT. So we'll start abdominal breath. The body is completely relaxed. There's no tension in any parts of the body. Start observing your toes. All the toes on the left leg and the right leg. Soles of the feet. Shift your focus to the ankles. Then to the shins, both shins. And slowly doing your knees. Move right up to the thighs. And the pelvic region. Start observing the whole part of your lower part of your body. You try to chant an akara to relax completely the lower part of your body. Let's chant, when you're ready, let's chant ah. So after your next week, inhale, you can start akara. Okay, start. So the lower part is complete, it's relaxed. We'll be moving to the middle portion of the body. So slowly start observing your stomach, abdomen, and the chest. Both your shoulders, your hands, your fingertips, your neck region. Try to chant in Ukara to relax. So when you're ready, let's chant in Ukara. The lower part and the portion of the body is completely relaxed. Let's relax the head region now. So you start observing your chin, cheeks, eyes, the ears, the head region, back side of the head region, and the lobes. You slowly chant a makara to relax our head region. So when you are ready, start chanting ma. All parts of the body are completely relaxed now. Slowly start observing your breath. Feel the relaxation in the entire body. few deep breaths. Chant an omkara to relax the entire body. When you're ready, and next, after your next inhale, let's chant omkara. Feel the complete relaxation in the body. Set up your body, raise your right hand up, left hand and open, slowly turn to the right, with the help of both hands, slowly turn to the face of body, keep your eyes closed. We will close with a closing mantra. You can repeat after me.
Sukhinah. Om sarve bhavantu sukhinah.
Sarve santu niramaya.
Sarve santu niramaya.
Sarve bhadrani pasyantu.
Sarve bhadrani pasyantu.
Ma kaschit dukkha bhavave.
Ma kaschit dukkha bhavave.
Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
You move your hands towards your back, tap your right hand with the left hand. As you inhale, the slightly stretch bend back. And as you exhale, slowly bend forward. The next exhale, slowly come back up. Your hands to mascara the ground, so you rub both your palms. You try to close it. Nice. Then you're ready. If you move your hands, you can rub as if you are reading books. Slowly close the eyes. Slowly open the eyes. Okay, done.
Pretty good.
Yeah, done.
40 minutes. 40 minutes. So one person is not there, so otherwise that's the reason we're trying to have the entire thing for 10 minutes. Otherwise, initially we thought 30 minutes, that would be each.